Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Mark again here at Weatherman Plus. I got some potentially good news. We still got some serious impacts coming from this system, but it is getting hit with this dry air on the southern side with that shear just really hindering this storm from doing anything. It's already at its max level of intensity now. And its max level is 92 miles per hour sustained winds, 115 miles per hour wind gusts. Now, this is going to carry the same strength across or weaken a few miles per hour before landfall in just a few hours, and is changing the impacts as well. Still got a serious strong storm surge that's coming with this issue, plus it's still going towards southern Mississippi, southern Alabama. That has not changed. I will update also what's going on with this system over here by the Carolinas. This is showing a little bit more strength. Matter of fact, just a little bit more. And I'm going to let you know what's going on for the rest of the tropical Atlantic and what's coming still at the end of this month and the beginning of October, our next serious storm that's coming after this one. Now, as we check and see what area you're in, if you're in this blue circle right here, your chances of getting tropical storm force winds, sustained winds of at least 39 miles per hour, but up to 73 also. If you're inside of this pink circle right here, this outer pink circle right here, this is hurricane force wind gusts. And if you're inside of this pink circle, all the way from Franklin towards Morgan City, this is where you're going to get hurricane force sustained winds. So just be aware of that. That's what we're seeing right now. And right now they're showing potentially it would be 92 miles per hour sustained winds. That would be on a weakening trend as it goes over landfall. And as we go further over, and anybody that's in between these circles, just use your imagination, draw a straight line, connect those together. If you're in this region, you're going to get the tropical storm impacts, sustained winds 39 to 73 all the way into Mississippi. But as you can see, we have multiple things to talk about, not just what the latest impacts is on Francine, what is going on when all these remnants get pulled over by the high pressure, and what's still out here. Because you can see we still have another formation that came in. It's going to be very weak. This right here is Invest 93L. It's actually becoming 707L. This is still going to be just a tropical storm, tropical depression and tropical storm that's going to linger to the west. This is going to get a sharp curve to the right. What we need to watch for is these over here. We have Invest 92L and we have Invest 94L. These two are going to linger a little bit further towards the west. Potentially won't impact us. But what I'm seeing is as still as we go towards later September, beginning of October, we're going to start getting issues again with things forming up somewhere in the Western Caribbean into the Gulf of Mexico region. So I'm going to give you the latest update on that as well. So if you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. That way you can get all the latest information that I post. Click the bell. That way you get these updates. Thank you so much for your time. If you have another moment, please click that like button down below. Thank you again. So you can see this on the latest of the intensity guidance that right now it is literally at the peak. There is one member says it could be a little bit stronger of a Cat 1 and starting intensifying towards landfall. Remember, that's the one I showed you earlier that showed a Cat 3, a Cat 4. Don't believe the hurricane model. It is just whacked right now. Everything is getting hit and it will either maintain or weaken down, and could weaken down greatly right at landfall, where it's barely even holding on to a hurricane status. Then it will be a tropical storm for the next 12 hours as it moves across Louisiana and across Mississippi. Now, what you got to remember is this storm system is moving faster, which is great. It's going to run out of time to get any kind of formation. It's also going to run out of time to weaken it some more, is what we want. But at the same time, it's also going to carry the impacts a little further inland and more across Louisiana and Mississippi because it's going so quick. At the moment, it is at 90 miles per hour sustained winds. It is moving northeast at 13 miles per hour. It is moving quick. You still have the tropical storm warnings in the blue regions, and you still got the hurricane watch over here from the North Shore all the way around towards New Orleans, and you still got the hurricane warning in the red. Now remember, these links are in the description below. Just click on Francine and you will see all this information. Storm surge inundation has changed. Matter of fact, look over here for this area. And you remember I've been updating this every single day. When you get to the yellow, you get 3 feet above ground level. You get to the orange, you get 6 feet. The red goes 9 feet. Look at this. So it looks like it's going towards Baldwin and Franklin. If you remember the last few days, we've been using this for a pivot point. And look how much more it has gone down. Now you still can't push away these impacts. You still got 3 feet. You still got above 6 feet storm surge. So it's still going to be a lot of issues, a lot of flooding still. But it has gone down a little bit. But you can see a lot of these places still got the blue and the yellow. That is 1 foot and 3 feet above ground level. And you can see over here also as it goes towards Gulfport, that you actually have something over here behind Waveland that could get 1 foot and maybe up to 3 feet in certain areas of storm surge inundation. You can see it along North Shore, pockets of 1 foot, and you can see other places is getting 3 feet. So please use the link in the description. You can always zoom in. It will update every time you click on it. Storm surge is pretty much the same as earlier. It is 3 to 5 feet, a little bit further now towards the western side, right on the edge of Vermilion Bay. And you see that 5 to 10 has gotten a lot smaller of an area. You still got the 4 to 7, you still got the 2 to 4 going around the boot of Louisiana, and you still got 4 to 6 feet going all the way towards Lake Pontchartrain. You got 3 to 5 for a little bit of Mississippi as it transitions to Alabama, and it slowly goes down from 2 to 4 still for Mobile, and still 1 to 2 for the Panhandle of Florida. The rainfall amounts for the next 3 days is still showing the exact same thing. Just a little bit more of a reach of that 6 to 8, just curving a little bit further to the east. Everything else is still the same. And remember, I have these links in the description for you as well. Not just the wind gusts, also the rain accumulation. So this is your wind gusts. This is a European. And you can see how it shows you can still bring anywhere from the 80s to the 90 miles per hour wind gusts. All the way from Dulac, Houma, past Morgan City, all the way towards New Iberia, going into Baton Rouge, and going towards Hammond as well, plus Laplace. Now remember, on the western side over here is where you're going to get a lot of that storm surge. And this is where it can start building up on your flooding on the road. So just remember that. Now this link is in the description. You can zoom way in and see all the information that you need to see. It is bringing some 90s with this. It is bringing some strong winds. And you can see right offshore, it is strong right before impact. 120 something miles per hour wind gusts. So it will be rough right on the edge. It will quickly weaken down, but weaken down status is still 90 miles per hour wind gusts, it may be even the high 90s, so it starts getting stronger. Then you have the 60s, then the 50s, it starts breaking down a little bit. But you can see it still goes northern, and look over here. As this maybe strengthens up a little bit off the coast, could start bringing those 50 miles per hour wind gusts with them. GFS sees it going a little bit further to the north. It all depends on where that high pressure is going to position off the coast or more inland, we will see. But it brings you a little bit further to the north on the impact. So we'll keep you updated on that. And it also takes us a lot weaker. It brings the 50s further north up and towards Tennessee, but a lot weaker on landfall. Now, hopefully you have all your plans in order and everything is done on getting ready for this system. Down in the description, there is a link. It's at getagameplan.org. This is from your Governor Landry from Louisiana. So if there's any last minute information that you want to know, any updates, it will be on this page. Please use this link. Now, after Francine, we still got the remnants coming to the east, getting pulled by the high pressure. Now, the Ural is taking it a little further to the south. GFS takes us a little bit further to the north before it goes on land. Not giving it a lot more strength, but still bringing maybe up to 50 miles per hour wind gusts with it. So now you can see we have Francine. We have what's over the Carolinas. 20% chance maybe in 7 days. This is just going to bring some tropical moisture and maybe bring some wind gusts. I'll keep you updated. We still have 7 that's in the back. This one isn't doing anything. And we have these 2 in the front, the 2 invests. This one has that 30% in 7 days, 30 in 48 hours. This one is just going to move to the west and curve but I'll make sure it don't go further to the west. We'll see. And this one also doing the same thing. 10% in 48 hours, 10% in 7 days. Just two strong little tropical waves moving to the west, but eventually going to curve. And that is these two right here. And you can see that for the majority, it curves on the one in the rear. But the one that's taking the longest to get itself together really is the one that you want to watch. Can they stay weak? And then they go furthest to the west because nothing really grabs them in the higher dynamics. And then they strengthen up late. So we do need to watch this. But this one has the best chance to go further to the west. So far, it could go right by the Leeward Islands. It could go further to the west. I'll keep you updated. These are just now starting to strengthen up out of nothing. But you can also see when you look at the latest of the ensembles that literally if it does not form up in the next 5 days and come on shore, it could get carried further to the north where it could start intensifying a little bit stronger. So I will keep my eyes on it. The majority is showing that this will go on shore, but just in case, we'll make sure nothing tricky happens with that wave. So you can see here from your latest update from your potential velocity anomaly that after you deal with Francine, this favorable environment we have was right off the east coast. And you can see the Euro don't give it a lot of strength. So this is telling me this is going to come on shore very quickly and it's not going to take that northern track. Still, I will keep my eyes on it. But you can see still, late September all the way to the beginning of October, we are going into a transition period where we still have the favorable environment for storms to grow and still showing the strongest storm is still going to be sometime around the end of September. It did show the beginning of October. Now it's showing a little bit more the end of September. Now, if you remember, we've been following this all the way from down here. I've done this for many hurricanes. This right here is going to be another big problem. Also, this one right here is not the one that's off the East Coast. This one is coming later. This one's in the Western Caribbean, in the Gulf, once again. And maybe even another one for the Western Gulf as we go through the first 10 days of October. It will update. I will keep you updated. This is what we have right now. Now, when the system comes on shore, it is going to start knocking your power out. Remember, all the heavy rainfall with the winds going to knock trees over. It's going to start knocking out your power. So remember, after this storm passes by for today and tonight, talking about Louisiana going towards Mississippi and moving north, your weather is going to get a lot better as soon as this passes by. So just remember that. So if you wake up tomorrow, you have no power. Remember, there's no storm coming near you anytime soon. Now, I know you still have a lot to deal with these storms, but in my eyes, even though there's still some serious impacts, this is actually good news that the storm is already capped off. It can't do no more, and it will start being on that weakening trend. So this is actually some great news. Everybody just hold tight. Wait for the storm to pass by. Let them clean everything up after it passes by. Be careful for all the first responders. Any way you can help them would be grateful help. Thank you for what y'all do. May God keep everyone safe that is a first responder. And before you go, one quick thing. Psalm 106, verse 1. Praise ye the Lord. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Amen. I tell you what, with that chunk getting chopped off by God on Beryl, then that chunk getting chopped off of Francine, you can see his work. You just got to look closely. Thank you, Lord, so much for having mercy on all of us and keeping us safe. All glory goes to God. Our Father in heaven, Yahweh, and I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great night, everybody. Hunker down. You'll be safe. The weather will be a lot better tomorrow.